Hello and welcome to Trucking Answers. I'm Mark. I've been a driver for over 30 years and I think we should get paid for all of our time. And we should get paid a good wage for doing it. We're licensed professionals after all. If you agree, it's time to subscribe. Now today, let's talk about layover pay. I want to go over some of these issues in the industry. Today, layover pay. Now I have a website, truckinganswersnation.com. You can go over there. There's a bunch of questions that I have on there that you can ask companies when you are getting ready to go work there. And one of them is about layover pay. So let's talk about it. Layover pay is when you are stuck without a load, generally is how it is defined. So a company will say, look, you are empty at say 3 p.m. Friday. And they go, we don't have anything, go park. That's layover. You're now being laid over. No matter if they give you a load in a minute or whatever, that time without a load, without a next load, is layover time. Layover pay should be paid. Here's how it works at some companies. They will say, okay, you have to wait 2 days, for example, and then you get $50 a day or $75 a day. Some say you wait a full 24 hours and then you get pay. Some give you layover pay right away. It's something you really need to check into. Because here's the thing, waiting 2 days and then getting $50, that's not great, okay? That's horrible. And so that is something you're gonna want to avoid, because not being paid, that's bad. And here's another thing companies do, so be careful about this. You'll get unloaded at 3 p.m. Friday, okay? And they go sit. And their policies, you don't get paid until you sit 2 days, then you start getting $75 a day. Well, the Sunday crew comes in and they'll give you a load at 3 p.m. Sunday, and that's not quite 48 hours yet. And that load picks up Monday, but it doesn't matter. You've got a load, you're not on layover. Don't tolerate this, don't accept this. Remember, know your worth, okay? Companies that do this, they're garbage. They shouldn't do that kind of thing. People should be paid, and there are places paying. Some companies pay a daily minimum, and that is excellent. So they may not have detention, so don't be too surprised about it, depending on how your pay is. If you're getting $250 a day, then it doesn't matter if there's detention, you're still gonna get $250 load or not. That's the difference. So some companies you'll get $500 for that time, and some companies you'll get no money for that time. Now that doesn't make any sense necessarily, and I don't certainly agree with waiting for free. Don't ever sit around for free. The reason that they do it is because you'll do it. You only sit free because you'll sit free. So don't tolerate it. When companies say you have to wait 2 days before you get $50 or something, ask them, are you serious? Are you people smoking something weird over there? And be really aggressive with them, because they need to know that drivers are not gonna tolerate this anymore. We shouldn't tolerate it. This sitting 2 days, 3 days, that they don't have a load, that's their problem. They need to find you a load or pay you. You're away from your family. You still have to guard their hundreds of thousands of dollars of equipment. And you know, you don't get to see your family. They go home to their family. No money for you. No way, don't tolerate it. When you ask them these questions, do not tolerate not being paid for days and days at a time and then only getting 50 bucks. I mean, that's crazy. So that's what layover is. It's sitting around without a load, waiting for them to send you another load. Be sure to get paid properly for it. Don't tolerate this 2 days, okay? Ask that question. And if they say, oh, well, there's hardly any layovers, then you say, oh, well, good, then why don't you pay for it? If it's hardly any layovers happens, then you won't mind paying for it. That's the thing of it. They don't want to pay you, even though they say they never do it. So be careful. Take a look at those questions. There'll be a link in the description for all the questions that you can ask, and it's not the be-all, end-all list. There could be more questions, all right? And we'll be back soon with more trucking terms here at Trucking Answers. Thanks for watching.